As a doctor, here's a man who's almost 50 years old, who has been swimming more than 2,000 miles over. What is his body telling him to do?
Stop. I'm sure.
Physiologically, what's going on there? As a physician, what risks has he been exposed to in the river?
Well, so far I've treated him for conjunctivitis because he got, obviously, the bacteria even get around the goggles that he wears. His ears had gotten occluded with, he was putting Vaseline in his ears, and so between that and the wax when that was in the dirty water, his ears got irritated. Now his skin is getting chafed from just all the days of wearing a wetsuit and chafing. It sounds like while this past week he got GI, gastrointestinal bug. think it just impresses me, the sheer stamina. I mean, knowing what he has to be able to do physically to do this. I mean, we rode along from Fort Madison, like Burlington Fort Madison area with him one day in the boat. You know, we have our lunch and we're sitting there after he has lunch and he's back in the water and then you get that after lunch lull and think, oh, I'm tired. And then you realize, he's out there swimming this whole time. We're sitting here feeling tired and lazy because we have our bellies full. He's out there swimming again. And it was just, it was incredible that you believe it, we just stood there on the dock for the last half hour because he had an agonizingly long day that day. He got in about 9 o'clock at night. It's pitch black. You know, they're trying to find a place to get him out of the water. Thought, you know, if we just stood here for the next half hour and just paddled air, our shoulders would be dying. He's doing it for 12 and 14 hours a day, you know, for 60-some days in a row. That's just, you know, to put the human body through that, to me, is phenomenal.
Dobra rybka,
St. Louis. You're completely wrapped up in this thing. Now you're in New Orleans. Yeah. Why?
Because some of it to show moral support, and just, you know, he's a neat guy. We thought, you know, this, how often do you get to meet someone that's going to set a Guinness, you know, Book of World Records? And they're just a neat group of people. The kayakers are all just awesome people. Pavel, his chef, is an incredibly unique character. I was like, okay, New Orleans isn't exactly a terrible destination city to go visit. So if we can roll some fun into that, and again, you know, I thought, it's a big lift for Martin. He's tired, and at this point, he can use all the support he can get. For 12, 14 hours, well, he's doing this, you know, every day for 2 months. Yeah.
What's your face now? What's looking at me?
What is the eye to eye?
That's good, yeah.
Am I in the way now?
No, that's good. That's perfect. That's what I want. Okay. Because I can take stills of this.
Oh, really? Okay. Thanks.
Matt. Right there. Right there.
Notice our hats
are
the weather-worn
right.
Hats
okay. Right.
Yeah, you can
from the beginning hats.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. They did start off looking that pretty.
Yeah. Yeah. I remember that.
He's in amazing 60 days. Yeah. Mm-hmm. They look better that way. Yeah. Much better.
Yeah, thanks. You wanted to give us new ones.
You probably wanted new ones for the pictures for today, huh? And you're like, no, this shows I've worked. Huh?
Bright, shiny blue hat.
Yeah.
No way. We're in these.
That's right. Anybody can get a bright, shiny blue hat.
Those hats have sweat equity.
That's
right. Literally. Yeah. Yeah.
To pull this out of the water. Good luck, Jeremy. Yeah.
Did you pull it out of the water?
No. No, it's
you can use that to catch dinner sometimes, too.
Emergency survival kit.
So there was a piece in the New York Times within the last couple of weeks about these killer carp.
You gotta be kidding.
Don't add anything else to their list of worries.
Killer carp, but they're carp that they used in these commercial fisheries where they grow catfish and that sort of stuff like that. They brought in these carp. Asian carp to help keep the ponds clean, the lakes clean. And in some floods, some have gotten out and gotten into the Mississippi. And these things are colossal size. They sometimes pop out of the water. They've been known to bang onto a boat.
Something nailed my kayak.
It was a fish, too. Oh, just, huge.
Oh, I was paddling on and all of a sudden nearly knocked me over.
Protein.